Sopranos, get ready to rediscover your reality like never before. But before that, let's quickly claim our Rival Week time research. The Rival Week is going on in Pokemon Go, and it ending soon today at 8 p.m. local time. So we have completed all the tasks. Time to claim our rewards. A Mankey, not a shiny. Machop, not a shiny. Liger, not a shiny. Shanshrew, not a shiny. Throw, not a shiny. It's a sock, it's also not a shiny. Special research completed. We got the fast TM, we got some XP, and we got rare candies, and the research is completed. So time to move on. Let's talk about the new feature. So Trainers, we are actually talking about the brand new feature known as Go Snapshot Revamped, or you can say Go Snapshot Upgrade. So previously, Niantic disabled this feature in Pokemon Go, so many of the players are raging over Niantic why they have done this. This is a very important feature they have removed. There is a reason why Niantic is doing it, because Niantic is beta testing a new feature, making this feature more improvised. After beta testing this with the selected trainers in Australia, they have some improvements and suggestion, and they have released this Go Snapshot feature globally now. All trainers above 20 will be able to use this feature. So let's move ahead and talk about this a little more. So trainers, in order to use the Go Snapshot feature, be sure your app is updated. So once you do that, open your Pokemon Go app. You have tapped the Pokeball icon, and you can see the new shortcut just below. During the new update, the icons have shifted. So if you are not seeing any three Pokemon to choose, your device is not compatible with the AR Plus technology to use the Go Snapshot feature. So be sure to change your device, and you can definitely use the new Go Snapshot feature. So trainers, once you're done with the tutorial, you can see different heads in the Go Snapshot. Suggestions will include the previously set Pokemon like feature groups and the popular groups, Kanto, Blossoms, Pink Pals, and First Partner. And if you want to select different Pokemons for the Go Snapshot, you can do that by selecting Pokemon. So let's do this right now, right here. So while using AR mode, make sure you are in a safe location and any children are supervised at all the times. It's a pre-recorded video. As you can see, you are provided with three Pokemons. Previously, there was option to tap on the footprints. Now you can actually select the Pokemon and you can move the placement circle around, so you can place the Pokemon right there. And if you see a red circle, that means that you can't place that Pokemon closer to that Pokemon. We have placed our second Pokemon and time for the third one, so let's place it nearby. Once you're done with placing the Pokemon on the background, you will see different icons like smile, camera, and rotate options. So previously you can rotate your Pokemon by just tapping on the Pokemon. With the new upgraded feature, you can use the little toy to rotate the Pokemon all around. This time you can actually let them face each other. So I rotate the Squirtle, then Charmander, and going to rotate this people up right here. It's so easy to rotate the Pokemons and let them face each other, become even more easier. Another important update I just noticed, that previously when we tap on the Pokemon, we got the angry animation while taking the Go Snapshot, but with the revamped Go Snapshot feature, you can take the happy face photographs. So to do that, you have to click on the camera icon. So once you do that, a countdown just begun. 3, 2, 1, the Pokemon will be smiling in the photos. The burst mode will be on, and it will take around 3 to 4 photos at one time, so that you can get the best photo out of the available clicks. After using the Go Snapshot feature on the ground type Pokemons, now it's time to use the feature for the flying type Pokemon. Let's see how it works. So we have chosen the Litten, Inkay, and Zubat is a flying type Pokemon. So we have placed the Litten and Inkay. Time to place the Zubat. Blue circle has appeared on the surrounding, so it is available to adjust the height of the flying type Pokemon. All you have to do is drag that line starting from the blue circle and place it wherever you want, and that certain flying type Pokemon will place on that height. So if you want to place your flying type Pokemon a bit low, take your Pokemon back and select the height of the flying type Pokemon again so that you can take a good snapshot here. So trainer, this is how you're gonna use this brand new quality of life update known as the Ghost Snapshot feature. So let me know in the comments down below your thoughts regarding this brand new feature. Is it good? Is it bad? Is it working on your device or not? So let me know. So yeah trainer, with that being said, thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe if you're new, and I'll definitely catch you guys in the next one. So until then, keep doing what you love, keep exploring, because as Niantic says, adventure is always out there. I will meet you out there very, very soon. Bye guys, goodbye. Happy Ghost Snapshot.